This tutorial is part of our full-stack React Django DRF channels project, DJ Chat. You can watch this tutorial and many more from our YouTube course playlist, or the whole course, including access to additional resources from our Udemy course. The Udemy course link, which provides the best price for the course, is in the video description. Source control is an essential tool for any software development project. In this course, we're going to be providing hands-on tutorials so that you can get some real-world experience with source control. If you do already have prior knowledge of source control, working with source control, then by all means skip these tutorials in this course. If you are new to source control, a quick introduction. Source control is a way to manage changes to your code base over time. It provides a history of changes to your code base, making it easy to roll back to previous versions if necessary. Before we start creating a project, we need to decide which source control system we'll be using. Now, there are several popular options, but Git tends to be the most commonly used for software development. So having chosen our source control system, we now need to install and then initiate it for our new project. And that is what I'm going to demonstrate in this tutorial. So before we start building our project, we're going to initiate source control for our project so that we can start then building the code base for our project. In order to follow along in this tutorial, I'm going to make the assumption that you have created a GitHub account. If you haven't done that, then just head over to github.com. GitHub is a free service, so you can go ahead and just sign up and log in. So GitHub is going to provide a convenient way of storing our code base, our Git repository, in the cloud so we can access it or maybe share it with others. Git is the actual source control system that we will be using, so we're going to need to install that on our machine. Now, to do that, what we can do is just type in download git. That would take us to, if you're using Google, that would take us to git-scm.com/downloads. So go ahead and click on that. You can see it's available for Mac, Windows, and Linux. So just go ahead, download, go through the installation process. That should be a straightforward process, and that will then be Git installed. To check to see if Git has been installed successfully, you can open up a terminal window, or if you're in Visual Studio Code, I'm going to select View and then Terminal to open up the terminal window here. So once you have that open, we can zoom in and type in git --version. So whether you're running Windows, Mac, or Linux, it should be the same. And you can see that I have Git version 2.40.0 installed. The last requirement is GitHub Desktop. Now, GitHub Desktop is a graphical user interface for the popular Git source control system. It provides us an easy-to-use interface for managing our Git repositories and generally just makes it easier for us to work with version control, particularly if we're new to version control. To download GitHub Desktop, just type in GitHub Desktop into your browser here, and it should then provide us an option. Now, top option here looks a little bit like this, download for Mac or Windows, and then just go through the installation process again. Once you have gone through that process, go ahead and sign in. That will effectively sign into your GitHub account, and then you'll be ready to start this tutorial. Assuming you now have everything ready, if you start GitHub Desktop, you should be presented with this screen. Let's get started. So from here, we're going to now create a new repository. So this is essentially going to be a folder, which is going to be tracked by Git to track any changes that we make within the code that's inside of that folder. So this is where we're going to be building our project, in this repository folder that we're going to now build. Right, so let's go ahead and create a new repository on our hard drive. So this option here, we're going to need a name. So I'm going to call this full stack. And then the name, Django DRF Channels React Project DJ Chat. Now you can call it whatever you like. Next up, select the path where you want to store this. Now, typically I don't change this. So this is going to be stored here on the Mac here in Documents GitHub. It's going to be very similar if you're on Windows. Now, you can go ahead and change this path if you like, but all my repositories are going to be stored right there. Now, in addition to that, we can initialize with a README file. We don't need to do that. That is something that we can add later. And the git ignore we'll discuss later on. And a license at this point isn't necessary, but you may already have an idea of the type of license that you want to apply to your code base. Go ahead and press create the new repository. You're now presented with this screen. What we have created is a new folder. If I click here, show in Finder, that should open up the Finder window, or if you're on Windows Explorer. Now, this is the repository in its current state. There's nothing inside of here. However, if I go ahead and maybe make a new folder, now it is an empty folder, so that will not get tracked. So in actual fact, I need to add something inside of this folder in order for it to work. So if you're on Windows, you can right click and make a new text file. So I've gone ahead and created a new file and I've dropped it in this new repository folder. Now notice if you go back to your GitHub desktop, you can see that Git is now tracking the changes in this folder. And you can see here that it's tracked the fact that we created this new file. Here in the Mac, I've also created a .ds store file. We can ignore that for now. The whole point here is that you can see that Git is tracking the changes. And through GitHub desktop here, we can see those changes and we can go ahead and what we'll be doing is committing those changes. So we're going to be saving those changes and we'll do that at a later date. What's important to note is that behind the scenes, there are some hidden files. If you're in a Mac, on the Mac, you're going to press Command, Shift and Dot. That's going to open up these hidden files here, these dot files. On Windows, it's going to be slightly different. But the point is here that we don't want to delete any of these files here because that's all related to actually storing the changes that we've made in this new repository. So let's go ahead and delete that because we're not going to need that in our project. And that should then remove. And you can still see that we've got this DS store, which we can just right click and discard for now. And then we're back to where we started. So we're now ready to start our project. Before we start our project, let's go ahead and save what we've done here over to GitHub. So I've got an option here, publish repository. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Now and make an assumption that you have logged in which case you will have two options here, github.com, enterprise. So we're going to select github.com. That's what we've signed into. The name, we can go ahead and change the name if we like, add a description. And you can see there's an option here, keep this code private. So the repositories, the data, the software, the code that we store on GitHub, that can be private, which means that no one else can see our repository. So that is an option that we can include. Maybe we want to create an open source project, in which case we wouldn't select that so that anyone can see our code base. So that's optional. I'm going to keep that private for now and then publish this repository. So once I've done that, all that's happening here is that all the information, all the changes that we haven't made so far are going to be then stored over at GitHub. So what I can do now is view this on GitHub. I just bring this down and you can see that's our new repository now created on GitHub. And we can then start to potentially view any changes that are made. So we can now view our project saved securely on GitHub. Here we'll be able to see or track all the changes that we've made, as well as perform some additional actions. But this is a really handy way of storing our repositories online so that we can perform some additional tasks. So for example, if we wanted to actually deploy this application, we can do that directly from GitHub. So that is a really convenient approach of deploying and managing our project. In addition to that, obviously it makes this project available to others. Most projects, we would want to potentially collaborate with others. So having this code base available online in this space makes it easy for us to collaborate with others. Now that we have our project repository, we can now start building our application.